We hope you're having a great day. We start today's program off with a serious topic, showing respect when people are different than us. Did you know that human beings are 99.9% genetically the same? That means that we are all much more similar than different. Then why do we tend to focus so much on how we are different? Some middle schoolers think it's funny to make fun of people who are different than them. People can be different in the way they look or what they wear, their cultural background, their ethnicity, their interests, hobbies, and overall personality. One of the reasons that we have advisory is to develop an appreciation for how different each member of the Wolfpack is and yet how we can come together to create the best school in the universe. Recently, Mrs. Wadling noticed students saying things about people's ethnic differences, and she sat down with Mr. Pierce to explain how it feels when others ridicule or make fun of them or something about them.
Okay, well, hey, Ms. Wadling, how are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
Well, I'm fine, thank you. I appreciate you discussing a really important topic for everybody in the school, and that's the power of words and how or actions as well. Tell me, you were kind of expressing some concern that you saw some behavior from kids that were very hurtful.
Yeah, so it hasn't been in every class, but there's been a few classes where I've had to stop and have some conversations with some individuals. If a student is saying ching chong and, you know, doing it to make fun of Asian students or how Asians talk, just letting them know that that's inappropriate and not desired at the school and not treating others with respect. So that's an issue that I've had come up several times.
So essentially that phrase ching chong or anything else that refers specifically to a racial put down, tell me how those things make you feel.
Honestly, I would say that it's really hurtful, and like when I was a kid and I would hear it, I didn't really understand why it was hurtful, but then now knowing as an adult what it means and that it is a racial slur and it's making fun of people in the way that they talk, even if, you know, you and your friends are just joking or kidding around and you think it's a joke, it's really not, and it makes people feel uncomfortable, it makes them feel less than, and I just feel like it shouldn't, that's not, you know, the message we're trying to send to people.
Yeah, and there's a lot of ways that people can make fun of some kind of attribute. Attribute's a fancy word for something about you, whether it be your ethnicity, it be your hair, your clothing, the way your body looks. All of that would fall into a category of really just mean, hateful behavior. Would you agree with that?
I would agree with that, yeah.
Yeah, okay. So if you, one parting message to the school as far as thinking about what they say and the words they use, what would you say to the school?
I would just say that if you think that it could be questionable or make someone feel like it's a put down, or if it's you, you know, saying something or someone's culture, something about them is weird or different, maybe think before you say it and don't say it at all. Maybe ask your friends, like, hey, if I say this, like, is that offensive? If you have to question it though, it probably is. You probably just shouldn't say it.
Yeah. That's good advice. What I notice is that a lot of times middle schoolers will be empowered when people laugh. And it seems like laughing just encourages people to be mean to each other. So I think it's really important that kids understand that if they're laughing with someone, they're condoning it, and they might as well be saying the mean, hurtful things as well. So we really need people in our school that can stand up in an appropriate way for good choices and for kind respect to each other. Would you agree with that?
I'd agree with that. I think that being an upstander is something that's really hard, but it's something that, you know, you should always try to do.
Yep.
You'll feel really proud about yourself at the end of the day if you can say that you did that.
Yep. All right. Well, thank you, Ms.
Thank you.
Do you have a special talent? Well, listen here, folks. We're doing a school talent show, so if you want to show off your awesome talent to the entire school, sign up for our May 12th and 15th. Have fun.
We're back for a brand new season of Chinook Got Talent.
It's amazing! It's inspiring! Perform by yourself or with others! This year is going to be sweeter than ever because of the last couple of years and what we've been through because of the COVID pandemic.
Whether you can sing, dance, tell jokes, or play an instrument, we want to see you.
What are you laughing at?
Look, it's Addie.
Is that the yearbook?
Yeah.
I wish I would have bought one.
You could have.
Well, I wasn't here at the beginning of the school year.
Yeah, but they were selling them like back in May.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. I wish I would have bought one.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Oh, dang.
Remember, Wolves, if you didn't buy a yearbook at the beginning of the year, you can buy them again now. But remember, there's only limited sales, so if you're going to buy it fast. They're $25 in the office.
Ducks. 10 kids, 11 kids. I almost want to give the 6th grade to Evan.
So nobody had under 10 then? I don't see that you modified it.
No.
Okay.
10, 11 was the last kid.
All boys. Chili dogs.
Yeah, so it's all boys.